Morning, MacAfee Road students and staff. Today is Tuesday, May 12th. The temperature is expected to rise to 60 degrees and the sun is coming out. So that's a good thing. You know, you all have done such an awesome job with all of the projects. You did a great job with the Rainbow Project, with the Gratitude Project, and participating with our Spirit Week activities. So this time, I'm going to ask you to now shift your lens or your focus and now zero in on ourselves. And we're going to launch a new project called the Reach High Challenge Project. And what that means is that we are going to focus on creating goals for ourselves. For example, my goal is going to be a nutrition goal. So what I'm going to do is make sure that I drink a gallon of water per day. That is a specific goal. It's water. It's going to be measurable because I'm talking about drinking a gallon of water per day. It is attainable. I'm already drinking 64 ounces, so I could push myself. It is relevant. I really want to do better with my nutrition. And it's time bound. It's going to be for 4 weeks. So we would actually end on June 12th. If we start on May 18th, which will be really the day that we launch our project. So you're also going to make a SMART goal, and you're going to talk with your parents about it, and then we're going to work together to achieve that goal and check in and encourage each other so that we can all celebrate on June 12th. So start thinking about that goal, because on May 18th, we will begin. Yesterday, I promised that we would start our new segment called A Story to Tell. So I do have an original work by Julian Howell from the second grade. And the name of his story is called Time Kids, Monsters of the Deep. I'm only going to read 2 pages. He really did an amazing job. Listen. Chapter 1. My name is Julian, and my friend Jackson and I didn't mean to buy the time machine. We just thought it was a playtime machine. But I should start at the beginning. Jackson and I were sitting on my couch, hanging out at my house, trying to find something to do. Ugh, I'm so bored, said Jackson. If we don't find something to do, I'm going to lose it. Relax, man, we'll do something, I said. When? He said. How impatient. Okay, I'm thinking, I said. We could get lunch, I suggested. Too early, said Jackson. Okay, want to watch something, I asked? No, I can't watch TV for a week, and don't ask why. Why, I asked. If you really want to know, I got grounded because I broke my little sister's tablet, he said. Oh, teach me how, I exclaimed. Oh, I'll teach you something, he said. I'll teach you how to feel the wrath of me. He tried to punch me, but I pushed him away. You're really funny, I muttered. Really funny. He did that every time I made a joke. Literally. I was trying to think of something to do when I heard a knock at the door. I'll get it, I said. I got up to answer the door. When I opened the door, I found a package addressed to my dad. I brought the box inside, and then I asked Jackson if he wanted to play a game. Nah, he said. Well then, I don't know what to tell you, man. He replied, I'm totally going to freak. Wait a minute, my mom gave me $20, I said. So, Jackson said, so maybe we can get out of the house and go buy something, I said. Awesome, exclaimed Jackson. What could go wrong? Nothing, I replied, but I was terribly wrong. Wrong, wrong, wrong. Oh my gosh, what an amazing story. I can't wait to read the next chapter. Julian did an amazing job with his punctuation and his dialogue, so I knew exactly how to read it and what the character was feeling. Great work with the story to tell. This book is 30 pages, so I am going to finish read all of it. Amazing work. Now, I also need to tell you about this. We are also launching today our remote learning ticket. So the same way we have our reach high expectations at school, we have some reach high expectations at home. And some of those expectations include staying focused, working quietly, helping a sibling, starting on time, completing all of your work. So you are going to learn about how you can earn a virtual remote learning ticket by meeting those criteria. Make sure you ask your parents to check their class dojo. Well, that's it for now. We said a lot today. Remember, do your personal best when completing iReady in all your assignments. And whoever does the work does the learning. So keep working hard, stay on track, and remember, you have a story to hear and a story to tell. And don't forget those other reach high expectations. We are respectful, we are responsible, and we are in control. Have an amazing day of learning and fun, and there will be another guest speaker tomorrow. Bye-bye. So everyone reach up, put your hands together.